We've now identified these four different kinds of relationships. So now it's time for us to figure out how to actually reflect these in data. How do we actually set up some kind of relationship inside of a table? All right, so we're going to introduce two other pieces of terminology and understand how these two additional things are going to help us set up these different kinds of relationships. So these two new pieces of terminology are primary key and foreign key. Primary keys and foreign keys are additional columns that we're going to add to a lot of different tables inside of all the different databases we create. Every single table we ever make is going to have a primary key. Now, you might notice that up to this point in this course, we have not created any tables with a primary key. Moving forward, every table we make, we will be giving it a primary key. The goal of a primary key is to identify an individual row inside of a table. Every value inside of this column is going to be some kind of unique value in that column. So for example, the first row right here in a photos table might have an ID of 1. So this is this row's primary key, an ID of 1. There will never be any other row inside of this table with an ID of 1. So if I ever reach into the photos table and ask for the photo with an ID of 1, I will always 100% of the time get exactly that row right there. Even if we sort the values inside this table, and maybe that row ends up down here, if I ask for the row with ID 1, still I'm going to always get exactly that row. So the goal of a primary key is to uniquely identify this row inside of a table. The ID is always unique, and it's never ever going to change. That's our first little piece of additional terminology. Now, to actually set up a relationship between two different records, this is the important part. We're going to use something called a foreign key. The goal of a foreign key is to somehow relate this record right here to some record in possibly another table or even the same table. So in this case, we have a table of photos and users. And you might recall just a little bit ago, we said that a user has many photos. So we need to somehow set up a relationship between these different photos and a user. To set up this relationship, we are going to give our photos table a foreign key column. We're going to call that column user underscore ID. And inside of this column, we're going to store the ID of the user that this particular photo, so this one right here, belongs to. So in this case, we would say that this row and the second row right after it belong to, or are somehow owned by, or are somehow related to the user with ID 4. So over here inside of our users table, we have a primary key column as well called ID. So we would look up the user with ID 4 over inside that table. There they are right there. And there they are right there. So we've now formed a relationship. We are somehow related these two photos right here to the user with ID 4 right here. That is how we are going to implement a one-to-many and a many-to-one kind of relationship. Remember, those two are very similar in nature. It really just comes down to the perspective that we are viewing this from. So now we could write a query that might take a look at our photos table. We could take a look at all the user ID values inside there. We could say, give me all the photos with a user ID of 4. And that would give me all the different photos that are associated with this user right here. And that's the idea. So if we wanted to find all the photos that were associated with user ID 1, so maybe this user with username Monahan93, we would take a look through our photos table. We would look at the user ID column. We would find all the user IDs inside of here that were equal to 1. So in that case, or in this case, it's this row right here. And we would be able to say that this photo is associated with user 93. And then same thing with the last one right here. If we want to find all the photos associated with Pfeffer, I guess is how we would pronounce that. That user Pfeffer has an ID of 2. So we'd go into photos, take a look at the user ID column. Okay, in that case, here's the only photo associated with that user. And so we would say this photo belongs to user Pfeffer. All right, so that is the basics of setting up a one-to-many or a many-to-one kind of relationship. We're going to make sure that all of our tables always have a primary key column. In general, we are going to store numbers in there, The value inside there is always going to be 100% unique, and it's never going to change. Then to set up a relationship with a row inside of another table, we're going to add in a foreign key, and we're inside that column, we're going to say, here is the ID of the user associated with this photo. Now, the first time you see this entire setup, it gets a little bit confusing. So let's take a look at a couple more examples and really better define this whole setup and go through some examples as well and get a really good idea of how we set up and maintain these relationships.